Oh, did you go to her? Why are you laughing? You've not been to her workplace. Amen. So anyway, now, the thing is, what I'm saying, so I will sit down in church like this, and I want to see some elderly people, and then reading Christian, you know, you want to find sense of belonging, you want to go to a black, you know, people church where, you know, you see people of your color, and I will sit down, I'll be interpreting to the elderly around me. Mm-hmm. And I came to them and I said to myself, I said, then we sit long. All our pastors there, well, let's start something. All the reading we had then, we are now up to 50. Not 50, but 50, 20 parishes today. And every redeemed God, they will put it and then no vernacular, meaning that you don't speak any other language other than in English. And here some grandparents, they want to have a sense of belonging in the church. And here a small boy like me will sit beside them and interpret what the Englishman is speaking. And I have to interpret the sense. Oh, why don't let us start something that other people can benefit to? We should not speak, I mean, we should not sleep on their face the same way. Let some people face this side. Let some other people face this side. At the end of the day, we make heaven beautiful. Look at my brother. Amen. Heaven is going to be beautiful. You know, because there's a language that heaven recognizes that we all must have. Amen. It won't be English, it won't be French, it won't even be that any African, you know, dialect or any, you know. So, my point is this, and as we were doing that, and we spoke to our leaders those days, as God we have, they said, years, years back, they've been nursing something like that. But they never got across their mind that we can ask somebody to do it. Of course, it's very challenging thing. How can somebody who came to England, you know they speak English, say, you want to send it to Pekka and be speaking African dialect? You know, except you volunteer. How are you getting me? Because nobody apply for such. Even if you want to be a pastor, the first thing they will know is that you must speak English. Yeah. Is that not? So we just said, look, let's be doing something different. Let's do something different. You know? Amen. For example, if such church like Swahili or another is not in this one, that means the mommy will not be going to church. It will be doing church on his own, on our own, at home. Praise God. And only Swahili, maybe, or only Sicilian, the granddaughters and all that will be member of our fellowship. Because those are the only ones who can communicate. But thank goodness that, well, today is a changed story. Amen. So that we, well, that's how the genesis of Rock of Redemption, that's known in our African dialects as this. Then, by the grace of God, they joined us. And it was like, then we were many. So I knew we were many. We were like, God, and I so much like their songs. I like it. Anyway, don't let me stress it too much. So I like it in the church. So that was it. But I believe today that through that, I'm sure Brabob will speak more of English than Swahili. And I believe that my daughter here will speak more of it. And I know mommy may not be able to go and bring white, but she can marry to a white person.
Yes.
I hope you're getting it. See how colorful. Yeah. Amen. Amen. And that's how this church must be. We don't want, you know, I hope you're getting it. We don't want coconuts. You know, brown outside, white inside. Praise the name of the Lord. Everything will be colorful. And I know heaven will be colorful in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let's learn a few things about this fish. You will agree with me that everybody needs a help. You also, you and I, we need a helpmate. It doesn't necessarily mean your wife or your husband. There's somebody God will need to raise for you to help you. And that's exactly what I mean by your miracle fish. Your fish represents that person that will bring you your joy. That will show you the way of salvation. That person who will show you the way to the next level. God will bring those people across your way in Jesus' name. And when you see them, I pray, just like mommy recognizes it, amen. And there's one other one that she failed to share with us, that if everything goes wrong, I'll go back to home. Home is Rock of Redemption to her. Yeah. I will always go back to my home, pastor. I can't forget, anytime we are meeting, if anything happens, I will go back to where
I came from.
But in Africa, when you give a woman, a lady in hand to her husband, we don't expect her to back home. Mommy, you go ahead. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
So, one thing, let's begin to learn this. Do you have something to write down? From the passage of the scripture, we notice that what happened, the incident happened at the time that Jesus and Peter went to Capernaum, was a shameful experience. I hope you know that. You know, shame apprehended them. Lack invited them. They never thought that they would make this challenge. I hope you're getting me. Just like you and I, you don't know what happened next. But one thing that is should be registered in your mind that Jesus is with you.
Yes.
It's your joker.
Amen.
It's your cash card.
Amen.
I hope you're getting me.
Amen.
So don't be afraid of what is coming across your way. Mm. What you need to know is that is Christ with me or is gone far? If it's gone far, call on him. I say, don't go far, Master.
Amen.
I need you at all times. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So get that one, number one. That problem goes everywhere. And everywhere, everybody will face this challenge. It's just that the degree of your challenge may be different from my own. But everybody will face it. But I thank God that because God has the power to turn our pains to praise.
Amen.
He will do that for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
For in this place, we see that they had Peter and Jesus at that time. Even can you tell that Jesus was with Peter, and yet they had problem. So because you're a Christian, you are not exonerated. You are not accepted from the vicissitudes of life. You are not from the challenges of life. So because you're a Christian, in fact, you are the one approved to. In fact, you are the one that the devil has, you know, advertised, wanted. So you need to know that you don't go near where they can arrest you. I hope you're getting me.
Amen.
You know, you don't go to sinner, you don't become a sinner's friend again. Not that you won't be a friend, you understand what I'm saying? You know, friends at different levels, you relate with people. I hope you're getting me. But you don't go beyond your boundaries so that you don't get caught. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And so they had a problem, but the problem again is a good problem because Jesus turned the problem around and he will turn your problem around tonight in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That's number one we notice there. They had problem. Even Christ was with Peter. Christ himself. Yet, Peter had problem. So because you are born again, so don't say, I'm not supposed to have problem again. You could see Peter even walking side by side with Jesus Christ at the time, yet he had problem. But the thing that you must, conclusion of the story that Jesus took away a problem. He will take away your problem.
Yes.
I say he will take away your problem.
Yes.
Number two lesson we should learn from this passage of scripture that I guess that it will bless us tonight is that I noticed that obedience provoke positive results from God, with God. When you obey God, anytime you obey God, let's bring it to our parentship, you know, types of, when we are under our parents, they give us all kinds of things. They promise us that if you are best in your school, I will do this and that for you.
Mm.
And we know a lot of us that we know the moment we get the target, we go and tell them, we remind them, to remember this and that. And the same thing, is with God. When we obey God, it provokes God's joy. It provokes him to do what he has promised, even beyond what you can imagine. But the problem that we have with God is that to obey him is a challenge for us. It's a big challenge for me and for every one of us. And that's why we need to pray to him that God, release your grace upon me. In the midst of all of this, help me to obey you. If you can obey, he will see you through. I hope you're getting me. But when we come to crossroads, the thing that has come to our mind first and foremost is that I have wisdom now. Can't I use it? I have sense now. Can't I use it? In fact, a lot of us, including myself, that we don't think we need to pray to sit on share. I don't pray. I must confess. But there is nothing too small to pray for. I hope you're getting me.
Amen.
That's the reason why, because you don't pray to sit down, somebody who is sitting next to you can just draw the seat and you sit on the floor. If you had prayed, you wouldn't have done it. It doesn't happen to you.
Yes.
When we are growing, it happened to us. It happened to me. You thought that the seat is there. Mm. And you just draw it. Sit on the floor. Yeah, I said, sorry, I'm just, you know, it turned into form. How are you getting me? And from there, you can break your But think about that. Supposedly, you are somebody, when you come to church, you first of all kneel down and pray. You will see the chair before you kneel down. Your head will touch it, isn't it?
Amen.
Just like when I came. How are you getting me?
Yeah.
But what am I saying is that we all face these difficulties time to time, but we fail to call on God. Because we have sense. These five senses are there. We can use it that. We have eyes. We have this. How are we getting it? But we're getting it wrong. So he gave us the eyes. He knew that we have that. The Bible says, the one who gave us ears or gave us mouth, he too has that those things. For the person who can pray, that's another God who can answer. That's the reason why we pray. Otherwise, we don't need to pray. Praise the name of the Lord. So obedience provoke God to do what? To give us positive results. And every result in your life, God will turn around for a good result in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So in the days of Paul, in the days of Peter, we saw that Jesus Christ said what? Say, cast that thing into the sea. He said, what? I said, the fish that first comes from the door, check it. He followed the instruction to the letter. And as he did it, the shame wiped away. Amen. And I'm sure those who are looking for years, we have caught them. At the end of the day, it was like, look, how did they manage to pay? They didn't come with any money. How did they get it? And do you know that if you, each time you call on God to intervene in your situation, those who are waiting for your shame, they will take away your shame. Amen. And because that shame, God can turn it around for fame for you. So shall it be in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So obedience to instruction guarantees a positive result. I am talking about knowing fully that this person is telling me to do this thing. I know it won't fail me. For example, if Daniel and mommy, any of us are young ladies that are not yet married, and they say, come and stay in my house, I should be confidently guaranteed that nothing will happen to my daughter. I hope you're getting me. That should be for you. That should be for me as a Christian. That when I say it, I am not saying that when we say we are coming 5 minutes, of course, sometimes we go beyond 5 minutes. But you know, oftentimes, we in the Christian world, disappointments are so enormous. But guess what? If we are to go to place of work, we will come. We are running late. Because we know that they will fire us. You do it one time, they warn you by mouth. The second time, they give you a note. The third time, you force the panel. The other one again, your probation is terminated. And you don't want to do that, is it? But in the house of God, we know we are meeting 5 o'clock, isn't it? Even when we are running late, you say, at the end of the day, is that not that we are asking for my offering? You don't know, the offering you are giving is why God is keeping your job. Because he knows you are supporting something positive. The Lord will support us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Can I share two more before we close? Amen. So, I also noticed that in fishing industry, for some of us, if you don't know, you go and learn it in the website. Thank God Google is there. Google it. When they say go out, you want to fish, and you want to use hook, you need a bait. There is no fish that will come around your hook without seeing anything on that. You understand what I'm saying? They told them that if you want to take something from a shark, have another thing to replace it. Then you will not see any tears running down the cheeks of that shark. When you want to throw your hook to the sea, you must prepare a bait for the fish to catch. What am I saying? Nothing goes for nothing, ladies and gentlemen. It is true that Christianity, salvation, Jesus has purchased it for us. But you know there's a responsibility placed on us too. The Bible says, if you do not confess Christ, then you're out of it. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world, for he gave us what? Begotten Son, the best that he had. But if you don't receive and confess him, then you are nowhere in the kingdom. You're getting me? So your responsibility, your duty is to confess him. Is to say, God, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. I hope you get what I'm saying. And the same thing goes to us in all phases of Christian life. That God has issued words. It is your responsibility to find where am I in this journey. And as you put yourself in that position, God will not disappoint you. I have never seen man disappoints, but God never did do that. But a lot of us, we see, the devil has come to our mind. When you say, when I pay tax, who will spend it on itself? You are less concerned about that. When you work, who will remove your tax? How many times have you raised an inquiry that, look, I want to see how you spend my last month's tax. But yet, you have to do your complaint. Amen. Somebody said that, you see, if you know, want to know that there is a culture in the United Kingdom, break a law. They will tell you that there is a law. Ignorance of it is no escape. Because by the time they call my sister, if anybody drives through red light, what is that? And you said that you are breaking a law of light. Is that not? Traffic light law. And another said, yeah, I don't know, I just came from Africa. And they said, my brother, excuse me, sir. What happens if you drive through a red light? I say, well, if you live in Iraq, you know, you break light. They say, no, you don't have story to tell. You break it, ignorant, pay for it, £60. And then let's remove 1 point of your driving license. And if you don't have driving license, well, you pay for the fine. Praise God. So what am I saying? See, ignorance of excuses of the I don't know this in the Bible is nothing. It is your responsibility to buy the Bible, study the Bible, and the one you can hear from the pulpit, check it up and do and ask God's grace to help you for the enablement, and he will grant you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So I'm saying that to say that now you cannot without casting something, you cannot catch anything. If you don't sow, you can't reap. If you don't depart, you can't arrive. That's how life is. But a lot of us want to live where we have not sown. That's a shit too. Think about it. Somebody labor for it. Even though God has promised us that the riches of the Gentile become ours, it's because somebody has paid for it. And don't forget, when God promised that, he's promising faithful ones, not everybody. If it's everybody, then you don't need, you know, money will be loaded in your bank account. But I'm sure you know that our bank account is not full as equal. We have, you know, God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Say, God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I also notice another thing that, you see, whatever you desire to get from God, whatever you have now can get it for you. You use what you have to get what you need. I hope you're getting me. They had a hook with them, they had a bait, and they needed a fish that would carry their coins. And they used the hook. As you give your offering today, as you give your time today, your own responsibility is to ask God for the miracle. Forget about how they spend the money. I hope you're getting me. Of course, you know this place is not free. Even though if they gave them free, in the next 3 months, they will ask them, look, 3 months has expired free. We can't continue. We pay this. We pay that. This building is free, but electric building is not free. Energy is coming after us. I hope you're getting me. So you don't worry about how all of that. Because don't forget that he who promised you after giving your tithe is God, not the that Malachi. Does that register with us? When you read Malachi chapter 3, who promised you there? Was it not God? I will rebuke the devourer. I will do this one for you. Who promised? It's God. But you see, it will be the work of the enemy for you to hold it back and say, well, because they have not told me how they spend it. Tithe. But God didn't ask you that when you give the tithe, ask how they spend it. That's not part of the package. So anytime they say tithe and offering tithe, now something has said, hey, they come again. Then you must remember, I said it, that no other person but the enemy of your prosperity. And I pray that God will give us a revelation to that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shall we all rise to our feet? Shall we all rise to our feet? One other thing that's so important, because the common thing among all of us tonight is Christ. I hope you know that. And if Christ may not be here physically, but we have a principle, we have a book that he has encouraged us to follow. And if we follow it, there is an analogy in Africa, they say if you follow a river, it will take you to the sea. Because every water, every flow, every river ends up where? In the sea. If you don't know sea, you know river, follow that river. It will take you to the sea. I hope you're getting me. Now all of these things that I've said tonight by the grace of God, I speak on behalf of no other person but Christ himself. I hope you're getting me. He's the one who has promised all of this. Even myself can't do nothing. And I want you to know that as you are running this, I'm running it. Because I preach to you, in fact it's more dangerous than for me to go back and say, God, help me. I have preached, I've spoken to concerning brothers, so, but God, I don't want to be a castle. Tonight, I don't know. But one thing I know that is possible. I cannot force you, but I can speak the word about tonight. While all eyes are closed, I always encourage people to say, look, this place is not theater. You know, there's one national theater sort of in Waterloo. But this is not Waterloo. Even though it's Waterloo, we have designated this hour to meet with the Lord. And God is here with us. We may not see him, but things that we can see, he has made them all. Amen. So possibly you will have no Christ at all. What I mean by that, I'm not condemning you. Who am I to condemn you? What I'm trying to say is that you don't have any connection with Christ. You are just hearing it, you know. And some of us now, technology is what we are using. Our life cannot reflect it. But there is grace in the house. I hope you are getting me. I have not come to condemn you, like John chapter 8, verse 1 to 11. Christ was saying, he said, woman, I have not condemned you. Where are your accusers? They've all fled. Tonight, anybody that accuses you, the Lord will take care of them. In the mighty name of Jesus. While all eyes are closed, you just want to raise your hand wherever you are. I just want to pray with you. If I want to make jest of you, heaven sees me, you don't worry about that. As long as your name manifests in the book of life. That's all what you want. You are here tonight, you have not given your life to Christ. Or perhaps, like somebody said in a meeting like this, said, I used to give my life to Christ. I gave my life to Christ, but I've taken it back. But the things that I do, he said, I want to go back to God. I want to be reconnected. Tonight, so your experience could be like that. I say, Father, I want to get back to you, Lord. I want a new life, O God. In this new place, O God, I want to turn new, even for you, O God. You are here tonight, so therefore I want you just to significant, and I'm not bringing you out, I just want to pray with you. You are there, you need a prayer, you want to say, Pastor, please pray for me, for the grace, for the enablement, that I will walk this walk the way God wanted. Not the way I want it, not as I will, but as God wills himself. So you are here, when all eyes are closed, please just raise up your hands. I just want to pray with you, not for a show. That's why I say all eyes should be closed, so that you're not looking at anybody. I just want to pray, and I'm not even coming to meet with you. If I thought, if you raise your hands, you know, amen. I know Jehovah sees you. If God could give knowledge to Skype, you can Skype and see your people in Africa. How much more God? Even though we are under the roof, but he can see you too. So wherever you are being in this auditorium, as you lift up your hands, I just want to pray with you. Jehovah God, I want to thank you for my sister, for my brother, that have lifted their hands, Lord. Daddy, Lord, they have despised the shame, oh God. They couldn't even care less about whoever that opens their eyes to look at them. God, Jehovah God, Lord, you who can see all things, who can do all things. Jehovah, I pray, I commit them to Abraham. Paul said to Timothy, he says, I know whom I believe. He says, whatever that is committed to him, he is able to keep that to the very end. Lord, I leave this once before you, go. I pray, Lord, as they are getting reconnected back to you, Lord, that they will not be disconnected again. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that has been making them to go back to the one, Lord, whatever that has been enticing them, whatever that has been disconnecting them, Jehovah God, tonight, you will arrest those things in their life. In the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, that passion, that joy that makes a man to run after God, Daddy, Lord, grant unto them in Jesus' name. Amen. Whatever be the situation around them, Lord, they don't want, Lord, that perhaps that has been so powerful to them, oh God. Jehovah God, let them disappear in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord God. As they get reconnected to you, Lord, as the name is being rewritten in the book of life, Lord, I pray your name will not be taken out of the book of life. In the name of Jesus, you will not fall again. You will not fall prey. In the name of Jesus, you will not fail God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. Blessed be your holy name. While all eyes are closed, I want you to ask the Lord, just like that miracle fish, you know, swim towards Peter. And that was the end to his lack, end to his shame. He said, go every shame around me. Either the shame of my past, or my present moment, or the one that has gone ahead of me, waiting for me to appear, Lord. Remove them, O God, in the name of Jesus. I noticed that in the days of Peter, Jesus was accessible for Peter. You remember when he was on the sea, there was a storm, he cried to Jesus. Jesus showed up for his head. I remember again when he has labored over the night and he caught nothing when he was doing the fishing business. And Jesus also appeared to help him. Jesus will appear concerning your matters. In the mighty name of Jesus. As you yield to Christ tonight, as you say, Lord, I will go all the way with you. God will be yours, will be accessible to you. Jehovah will help you. And I leave this parish of the Redeemed Christian of God, Rehoboth, Rock of Rehoboth. I pray in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, yes. That when next I will be invited, you will be more than this. Yes. You will have been double. Yes. As it's been said, has been the desire of the pastor in charge, so shall it be in Jesus' name. Yes. I pray that no evil will befall you. Yes. God, the one who has given you fish will provide for you. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. Every need of this parish will be met in Jesus' name. Yes. And I pray the Lord, as you, the mother parish has been a blessing, you will be a blessing to the baby ones. In the name of Jesus. As I see Bob, as I see many of my brothers in the house, that they'll say, I want to go for Christ. I will say, no pastor will come and pray. So shall be the testimony. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.